Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding the diplomacy of business written by Sanjay Bharu. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2, plus this is very, very important from ethics paper point of view. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about the ethical aspect. Now what ethical aspect is involved in it? The ethical aspect, like, is it justifiable or is it ethical or is it legitimate for a business party to participate in the diplomatic process of our country? Now in order to understand this editorial, we need to peep into how the diplomacy has been working since the concept of nation and state has evolved. Now from the concept of nation and state, it becomes clear that anybody who would be representing the state should actually go in for a kind of engagement with another country. The concept of nation and state exhibits that only the heads of the state and the nations should be engaging with each other. But this has seldom proved to be true. On the contrary, what we had witnessed since this concept of nation and state has evolved, in the diplomacy, in the relationship, in the engagement between the countries, there has always been multiple stakeholders. Now, this was something that I was talking in yesterday's editorial also, of how we need to increase the stake of the stakeholders in the relationship between India and Pakistan. Until and unless we will not be doing that thing, we will not be able to sustain the peace and the harmony and the flamboyance in the relationship between India and Pakistan. In this editorial, Sanjay Bharu has talked about that it is not unethical to engage a business party, to engage a business tycoon, or to engage the corporate sector in cementing, in deepening, and in widening the relationship. Now when it comes to India and United States America's deal, nuclear deal, this deal was precipitated not only due to the political engagement between India and United States of America, but it also got cemented due to the pushing that was provided by the nuclear corporate sector of United States of America. Now the another deal that we have signed with Japan, that deal again has been cemented due to the push from the business community. Then India had signed up an agreement with Australia about the coal mining, and Indian government has helped Adani's to get a coal field in Australia. We are in a world where economy, where financial cannot be dichotomized, cannot be differentiated from the political aspect. Politics and economy, they are intertwined with each other so intricately that it is foolishness. It would be a foolish act to call upon to differentiate, to call upon to dichotomize them. If economy would be dichotomized from the political aspect, there would be no international institutions like we are having European Union. That under this entire European Union, it is all the business community's engagement. Then you have ASEAN. ASEAN is what is ASEAN? It's again the business community engagement. Now when the business communities, they have their interests in these engagements, in these forums, they tend to implicitly implicitly or explicitly influence the diplomatic relations of the countries. Why United States of America and Russia are not fighting war against each other? Why we are only witnessing the skirmishes, and the skirmishes are taking place only at places which are far away from these countries? The reason is all these countries, they are intricately related to each other by a umbilical cord, and this umbilical cord is the economic umbilical cord. Why United States of America is not waging a war against China to usurp or to dissuade its ascendantic agenda in South Asian Sea or in the East Asian Sea, East China Sea? It cannot do it because we have varied elements that guide this diplomacy. Economy is one aspect. Now, this editorial, it is written from a very myopic perspective. Had the writer would have taken this holistic perspective, he would have also mentioned about how the religion plays a role. Take the case of United States of America and Iran. Ayatollah Khamenei is a very big weight in Iran. After Iranian Revolution 1979, Ayatollah Khamenei has been guiding the entire political thing of Iran, and it's because of that we had seen a big hiatus, a big chasm, a big gap in the relationship between United States of America and Iran. So the diplomacy of United States of America and Iran had an element of religion in it. Then we can talk about the diplomacy of India and Bangladesh and India and Pakistan. The diplomacy of both these nations, these triangle countries, these tri-countries, reflect to some extent an element of religion. So you can never have something called as pure political diplomacy. Pure diplomatic political diplomacy is actually a farce. This is a concept that exists only in theory. You will never find political diplomacy in reality, in practical sense. What will you find in practical sense is a kind of a diplomacy that is influenced by the economic factor, by the social factor, by the religious factor, by the cultural factor. So whenever we talk about any relationship like between India and Afghanistan, we talk about that we had a connectivity with that nation that dates back to antiquity, that dates back to 2000 years, 3000 years back. So why do we give these logics and these reasons to put forward that we have a very good relationship with a particular country? We do that because somewhere deep in our mind, we know that diplomacy, it is a kind of a bond. It is a kind of a concept that is multifarious, that is multidimensional. It can never be unidimensional. It can never be solely political. Now, when the international landscape is becoming multilateral, we cannot expect the diplomacy to be guided solely by the government. Now, we have the diplomacy of certain countries in the Middle East where it is guided more by the non-state actors. Hezbollah is guiding the diplomacy of certain Lebanon. Then Hamas is guiding the diplomacy of Palestine. RSS in a way is guiding the diplomacy of India. So there is nothing wrong if an economic weight, if a business tycoon is helping the two countries to come close, because this is not unethical, because diplomacy